Ja. Det er på tide å ta en prat med... Nei, FN har ikke feil. Prate med folka mine.
Anything you need, Commander?
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
I didn't figure you'd have time to talk with all that's going on. There's gotta be some xenobiologists who want to read about the Thorian.
The paperwork will keep. Something on your mind?
I'm just looking for an ear. The debriefing wasn't the right place to say how ridiculous this is. Seems like every other race in the galaxy is wrapped up in their own problems. They don't want to see what's coming.
Wanting to believe everything will be fine? Sounds like human nature to me.
Yeah, I guess some things carry across species well enough. I should remember that after what happened with Vernus.
I think you'd carry a grudge over the crap you took from Vernus.
Before I met Vernus, I knew as much as any other civilian. Aliens were weird, superior, and tried to tell us what to do. I mean, it's only been 26 years since first contact. That's not a lot of time, understand? It was Vernus who made me see how human aliens are. They're not different or special. Jerks and saints, just like us. Hell, by the time I got payback, I didn't even want it anymore.
I don't see you snapping very easily. What finally did it?
He hurt a girl, broke her arm. She reached for a glass of water instead of pulling it biotically. She just wanted a drink without getting a nosebleed, you know? Like an idiot, I stood up. Didn't know what I was gonna do, just something. And Vernus lost it. Beat the crap out of me. He kept shouting how they should have bombed us back to the Stone Age. And that's when the knife came up. A military-issue talon, right in my face. I cut loose. Full biotic kick, right in the teeth. Almost as strong as I can manage now. At 17, that's something.
Tapping that deep must have shocked the hell out of you.
Not as much as it shocked Vernus. It killed him. Snapped his neck. They probably could have saved him if they got him to an infirmary quick enough. But they didn't. Caused a stir when they shipped him home. Bot training was shut down. Kinetics folded a couple of years later. So, yeah, maybe I hated that Turian. I mean, if one ass was enough to judge a whole race, I'd hate humans too.
A reasonable stance. Keep that level head and we'll do fine.
Staying reasonable is about all we've got left. Everyone else in this galaxy seems to have gone out of their minds. Present company accepted, of course.
Takk for det. Jeg startet med Liara. Jeg husker sikkert på Noveria at vi drepte moren hennes, fordi hun står sammen så på Ceres sin side.
If you are here to talk about Benezia's death, you need not bother. She brought it upon herself.
In the end, maybe she's better off now.
Maybe. She was a good person once, before she was twisted by Sovereign's power. Better to remember her as she used to be.
The best of your mother lives on in you. Her determination, her intelligence, her strength.
That is kind of you to say. I appreciate your concern, but I am fine. Benezia chose her path, just as I have chosen mine. I am with you until the end, Shepard.
I like talking with you, Liara, no matter what the subject.
Then let us talk about you. Are you okay?
What do you mean?
You need to take care of yourself, Commander. The crew relies on you for leadership. It can be a heavy burden.
I've got broad shoulders.
I have no doubt about that. But can they carry the weight of an entire galaxy? If we don't stop Saren... No, never mind. I'm sorry, Commander. The last thing you need is someone constantly reminding you of how grim things are. Is there anything else you would rather talk about?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Hun tar det med stort ro. Ja, ja. Du er en tøff Asari. Det er det. Yeterli.
It feels like we're getting near the end, doesn't it, Shepard? With Saren, I mean.
It won't be much longer. One way or another, it'll all be over soon.
You'll find the conduit before he does. I know you will. You have to. And after this is all over, when my pilgrimage ends and I go back to my own people, I'll be proud to say I was a part of it.
We couldn't have done this without you, Telly.
You've been good to me. A lot of people treat Quarians like second-class citizens. They just want us to go back to our fleet and disappear. But you've treated me just like everyone else on your crew. Like an equal. That means a lot, and it says something about you. Whatever happens, I just want to say thank you for that.
I'm going to miss you when you go back to your own people, Telly.
That won't happen for a while yet. I'll be right here anytime you need me.
I should go.
See you later.
Yeah. Fortsett med god arbeid, Tali. Du har vært i stor hjelp for crewet mitt. Vi har pratet med Rex. Han en barsking. Han har gjort det veldig bra i denne episoden.
Shepard.
So, you'd rather be a merc than help your people?
I'm a fighter. It's what I do.
Aren't you at all worried about what will happen to the Krogan?
What the hell do you want me to do about it, Shepard? I'm tired of sticking my ass on the line and getting nothing for it.
So you're just giving up on your people?
I gave up on fighting for a lost cause. I'm not like you, Shepard. I'm no hero. Bottom line, killing for credits simplifies things.
You ever think about helping your people?
I try not to. But there's a lot of Krogan mercs out there. I'm always running into them. Half the time I'm being paid to kill them. But that's just part of the job. You don't get to pick who your enemies are.
You must have family other than your father. Don't you miss them?
You're trying to make me cry, Shepard. I've got some unfinished business with my family. But that's all.
What kind of business?
Before I left, I made an oath to my father's father. I swore to recover my family's battle armor. It was taken from him after the uprising.
Who has it?
Originally, it was taken by the Turian military. We weren't allowed armor or weapons after the war. Now, it's in the hands of Ton Actus, a Turian scum who collects relics from the war. He's made millions selling Krogan artifacts that were stolen from my people. He's got several bases where he stores his goods, all fortified and guarded. I just don't know which base has my family's armor.
Just tell me where to start looking.
I'll upload the data to your nav system. But Commander, I want to be there when you find him.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Takk, Rex. Jeg har fått en ny sideoppdrag. Det å hente familierustningen hans. Et annet sted i Argus Road Cluster. Ja, det skal jeg prøve. La oss ta titt på forskjellige equipe. Vær så god, gladiator. Har vi Tally sitt ting her da? Nei. Rex. Åh, vær så god. Nå er det mye sterkere nå. Her er det ikke noen du vil like. Eller jeg gjør det. Vær så god. Og vær snill sitt da. Heavy Armor Phoenix. Der! De andre skal jeg selge.
Commander?
Do you have a few minutes to talk one-on-one?
I'm off duty until tomorrow. I was gonna have a small drink. Bit of a celebration. If you're interested.
Last I checked, the Alliance Navy was dry.
All right. But you know, a still is the first thing the engineers install after engines. It's Armistice Day, when the first contact war ended. My family always marks it. Since I'm the only Williams aboard, I thought I'd ask you.
Seems like an odd thing to celebrate. That was 26 years ago.
In our family, it's not really a celebration, more like an obligation. Don't tell me you don't know about my family. My commanders always find out. It's not in my files or something?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm General Williams' granddaughter, the commander of the Shanxi garrison in the war. The only human ever to surrender to an alien race.
Don't tell me you're blamed for that.
Not formally. Dad got passed for promotion over and over. And I think my record merits more than garrison duty in a backwater agri-colony. It takes a special kind of big-headed to march into a job where your family's blacklisted. I did it anyway. I'm not gonna let our name go down with Arnold and Quisling. Granddad deserved better than that.
Is this why you're always going on about the Council?
If everyone else can look at Shanxi and say, this is why humanity needs to be stronger, then so can I. I'm entitled. So now you know. Gonna kick me off the ship, Skipper?
You're part of the team, Williams. I don't care what your grandfather did or didn't do.
Not to get all cheesy, but you're the first CEO who's ever said that to me. Thanks, Skipper. But anyway, I've got things to do before we land. I'm sure you do too.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
You mean the Rachni, right? Like I said, the Rachni are dangerous. They proved that 2,000 years ago. You made the right decision, Skipper. If you haven't talked to Dr. Tassoni, you probably should. She just lost her mom. That has to hurt. Just saying, Skipper.
Dismissed, Chief.
Sir.
Takk for praten. Hey, Garrus. Hvordan går det med deg? Du har tatt Dr. Tassoni igjen.
Commander, what can I do for you?
Something bothering you?
It's Saren. I'm starting to wonder whether we'll ever find him. He's always one step ahead of us, and he's got those damn Geth.
We're getting close, Garrus. We'll find him.
I wish I had your confidence. I just can't stand the thought of him getting away with everything he's done. I know you're doing everything you can, and if anyone can catch him, it's you, but if there's anything else I can do to help, anything, just tell me what you want me to do, and I'll do it.
Thank you, Garrus. I'll keep that in mind. Just make sure you're ready to go when we do catch him.
Yes, sir. I'll be ready. Can I ask you something, Commander?
What is it?
Are you worried that the Council might be protecting Saren? I mean, they were really dragging their heels before. What if we find him, bring him back to the Citadel, and they refuse to act?
You seem to have some thoughts on this. Speak your mind, Garrus.
Well, maybe we shouldn't give them the chance, Commander. In my opinion, Saren's too dangerous to be kept alive. Too much could happen. He could escape, or the Council might let him go. If we find him, when we find him, I say we make sure we stop him permanently.
If Saren won't listen to reason, if he forces my hand, I'll kill him in a heartbeat. But only if it's absolutely necessary.
But what's the point in keeping him alive? It just gives him an opportunity to escape or convince the Council to listen to him. And what about the Geth? They might try to free him.
We know more about Saren's plans than anyone. But what do we really know? If we just kill him, we lose the chance to find out.
Yeah, I see your point. Do you really think there's more to know, other than the fact that he's a raving lunatic?
Maybe, maybe not. But it's not a chance I'm willing to take.
Yes, sir.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
La oss selge de tingene her. Så er det tid å kjøpe noe nytt. Medium armor. Herregud, jeg har over 1 million kreditter. Da kjøper jeg den nyeste medium armor. Der. Wow, den stilig. Ok. Etter mye om og men, så avslutter jeg her for denne gangen. Så tusen takk for at du fulgte med på den lange, lange delen. Blir problem underveis, men det gikk bra. Jeg fikk rydda etter lavalampa, så det gikk noe problem. Vel, da sier jeg bare tusen takk for meg, og ikke glem å trykke like, og abonner, det helt gratis. Og tre av!